हेलो स्टूडेंट, इन मैकेनिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ फ्लूइड वी कैन डिस्कस अबाउट द टर्मिनल वेलोसिटी फॉर दैट पर्पज। डायग्राम हियर, in this diagram let us consider sphere. Here sphere is drawn, that is which moves fg force, gravitational force, that is acting in downward. Thrust force, that is Fu, and viscous force, acting on that figure. This figure is the forces acting on the object. When it moves through the viscous fluid, forces acting on object. When moving through the inner viscous fluid or moves through the viscous fluid. Let us consider the sphere. Consider spherical object flowing through this viscous fluid. Then different types of forces acting on that spherical object, that is gravitational force mg. It is acting downward direction, and up thrust force acting upward direction, and viscous force acting upward direction. We know that in last lecture we are discuss about that viscous force acting on the spherical object when it falling through the viscous medium, that is F. It is directly proportional to the eta rv, where eta is the coefficient of viscosity, r is the radius, and v is the velocity of an object. Where eta is coefficient of viscosity 6 pi, eta rv, where 6 pi is the Stokes constant, eta is the coefficient of viscosity, and r is the radius of sphere, v is velocity. When this spherical object moves through the viscous fluid, then this is the, according to Stokes' law, viscous force acting on that object. Then when this spherical object moves through this viscous fluid, then first force act up thrust force Fu acts in upward direction, and viscous force acts in upward direction. Happen force kuda direct honar hai upward direction. And third force gravitational
upward force on an object when it is submerged.
in a fluid, then it is called as buoyancy. That term is called as buoyancy. When this spherical object moves through the viscous fluid, then these three forces are acting on that object. Therefore, equation derivation of terminal velocity, it is given by in that case the net downward force acting, that is total net downward force acting, that is Fg minus Fb plus Fu, where Fe is the viscous force and Fu means a thrust or buoyancy force, Fg is the gravitational force. When this viscous force reacts in upward direction, then its velocity increases with increase in this force. But the stage is reached at which this Fg, this net force, it is equal to zero. When Fe plus Fu both are equal, then the net force acting on the stage is reached at which it becomes zero. Then at that time downward velocity remains constant. At this stage the velocity, downward velocity remains constant. Downward velocity remains constant, and the constant downward velocity, constant velocity attained by the object is called as terminal velocity. Then that velocity is called as terminal velocity. When net force acting on that object, that is F is equal to Fg minus Fe plus Fu, this acts in upward direction, this acts in downward direction. Fg means when this net force acting, the stage is reached at which net force acting on that object, it becomes zero. Then at that time, the downward velocity at this stage remains constant, viscous force is also constant, and that constant downward velocity attained by an object, it is called as terminal velocity. Then after that we can derive the expression for terminal velocity. Terminal derivation, at this stage total downward force is equal to, total downward force is equal to kya se, total upward force, total downward force, it is equal to total upward force. Total downward force jo ahe to kashamula create zalela hai, weight of an object that is m into g, that is total upward force. टोटल अपवर्ड फोर्स हा कशापासून आहे, कशापासून बनलेला आहे, दिस फोर्स इज ड्यू टू विस्कस फोर्स एज वेल एज, दिस फोर्स इज विस्कस फोर्स प्लस अप थ्रस्ट. विस्कस फोर्स काय आहे, एफ व्ही प्लस एफ व्ही प्लस एफ U. F U means a thrust or buoyancy force acting on that object. Then weight of object, where M is mass and G is acceleration due to gravity. Then we know that viscous force acting on that object according to Stokes' law, that is your V is equal to 6 pi eta R V, and upthrust force is Kiasel upthrust force. This sphere is made up of, it is of sphere, its volume is 4 by 3 pi R cube, having sigma density, and G is acceleration due to gravity. Therefore, in next line we can write, that is total downward force is equal to total upward force. We know that density is equal to mass divided by volume. M is equal to rho into V. We know that density is equal to mass divided by volume. M is equal to rho into V. This object is sphere, therefore its volume is 4 by 3 pi R cube. Rho is density of that, and 4 by 3 is pi r cube. Density is equal to mass divided by volume. M is equal to rho into V. M is equal to rho into 4 by 3 mg. Therefore, M means 4 by 3 pi r cube rho into G. M's value is from this equation 1 we can take. And according to Stokes' law, viscous force kaya hai 6 pi eta R V. Say this equation 2. Therefore, viscous force is 6 pi eta R V. We can take here, and buoyancy force 4 by 3 pi R cube sigma into G, because this object is also sphere and sigma is density of that medium, G is acceleration due to gravity, and sphere, volume of sphere is 4 by 3 R cube. This is the buoyancy force acting on that sphere. Therefore, we can write, that is, drag this term to that side, we can get here expression 4 by 3 pi r cube rho g minus 4 by 3 pi r cube sigma g, which is equal to 6 pi eta r v. Take 4 by 3 pi r cube outside, 4 by 3 pi r cube rho g, and remaining term is rho minus sigma. And we can write here 6 pi eta R V. Or, kiva solution to 6 pi eta R V. वी कैन हैव टू फाइंड हियर इथे काय फाइंड करायचं आपल्याला बीच वैल्यू फाइंड करायची त्याच्यामुळे काय करणार 6 π r v इकडे घ्या इथे काय शिल्लक राहील मग 4 / 3 π r³ रो माइनस सिग्मा जी काय काय कैंसल होते इथं पाय पाय कैंसल गेट कैंसल आर आर गेट कैंसल रिमेनिंग टर्म दैट इज ईटा वी ईटा वी 4 / 18 आर स्क्वेर रो माइनस सिग्मा जी हे काय होईल 2 / 9 देअरफोर इक्वेशन कॅन बी रिटन ॲज दॅट इज इक्वेशन कॅन बी रिटन ॲज v इज इक्वल टू 2 / 9 r square rho minus sigma g divided by eta yala equation 3 mana this is the terminal velocity of the object when this object moves through the viscous fluid this is the terminal velocity where r is the radius of the sphere rho is the density sigma is the density of medium g is acceleration due to gravity and eta is the coefficient of viscosity again coefficient of viscosity it can be find out by the expression 2 / 9 r square rho minus sigma divided by v into g say this equation number 4 this is the expression for coefficient of viscosity that is in this expression eta is equal to 2 / 9 r square means radius rho is density sigma is the density of medium g is acceleration due to gravity and v is velocity by using these two expression we can calculate the terminal velocity of an object when it moves through the viscous fluid and this is the coefficient of viscosity when it moves through the viscous fluid of an object this is about the terminal velocity thank you